Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Good morning, children. Hope all of you are safe in your place. Today, we are going to see an interesting topic in grammar, prose comprehension. Now, before getting into the topic, let's learn what is comprehension. My teacher, Mrs. Bhuvana, is always talking about comprehension. What is comprehension? Come, let's learn what is comprehension. Comprehension is thinking and understanding what you read. I'll repeat, comprehension is thinking and understanding what you read. Let's play a game. I will give you some clues. Your job is to think about the clues or what you read and then see if you can comprehend what is being described. I'll repeat. I will give you some clues. Your job is to think about the clues or what you read and then see if you can comprehend what is being described. Here are the clues. Use this to get clean. It is in the bathroom. It rhymes with the word rope. What is it? I'll repeat. You use this to get clean. It is in the bathroom. It rhymes with the word rope. What is it? Can you guess? Yes, it's a soap. Now, that's right. You thought about what you read and put the clues together. You comprehended what you were reading. Let's continue. Here are the clues. You fill me up with warm water. You find me in the bathroom. You get in me to get clean. What is it? I'll repeat. You fill me up with warm water. You find me in a bathroom. You get in me to get clean. What is it? Can you tell me? Yes. You're correct. It's the bathtub. You're doing fantastic, children. So, thinking and understanding what you read means you are comprehending what you read. So, I'll repeat. Thinking and understanding what you read means you are comprehending what you read. As you would have noticed, you were able to answer the questions by understanding the clues which were given. Thus, understanding the prose which is given is called prose comprehension. I'll repeat, you were able to answer the questions by understanding the clues which were given. Thus, understanding the prose which is given is called prose comprehension. So, let us read a prose and we will comprehend the same. I'll repeat, let us read a prose and we will comprehend the same. That will understand the same. Now, let me tell you a small story. Read this story about the four oxen and the lion. It's a story about four oxen and the lion. A lion used to hunt near the field in which four oxen brothers used to live. The lion tried to attack them many a time, but whenever he came near them, the oxen stood in a circle with their horns towards him. Whichever way the lion approached them, he could meet their horns. One day, they squarreled among themselves and each went off to graze on his own in a separate corner of the field. The lion saw his chance and attacked them. This time they could not escape. This story teaches that united we stand, divided we fall. I'll read the story once again. A lion used to hunt near the field in which four oxen brothers used to live. How many oxen were living there, four oxen. The lion tried to attack them many a time, but whenever he came near them, the oxen stood in a circle with their horns towards him. Whichever way the lion approached them, he could meet their horns, so he was not able to approach them. One day they quarreled among themselves and each went off to graze on his own in a separate corner of the field. The lion saw his chance and attacked them. This time they could not escape because each one of them were in different direction. So the lion was easily able to attack the oxen. So this story tells us, united we stand, divided we fall. Now let's answer the question. First question, how many oxen were there in the story? I'll repeat, how many oxen were there in the story? You remember, children? Yes, you are very correct. There were four oxen in the story. How many oxen were there? Yes, there were four oxen in the story. Second question, where did the oxen live? I'll repeat, where did the oxen live? Yes, the oxen lived in a field. The oxen lived in a field. Third question, how did the oxen stand when the lion came to attack them? I'll repeat, how did the oxen stand when the lion came to attack them? The oxen stood in a circle with their horn towards the lion when it attacked them. The oxen stood in a circle with their horn towards the lion when it attacked them. Now, the fourth question, what did the oxen do after the quarrel? What did the oxen do after the quarrel? The oxen started to graze in different corner of the field after the quarrel. Fifth question, what did the lion do to the oxen? What did the lion do to the oxen? The lion killed the oxen when they were separated. The lion killed the oxen when they were separated. So, what is the moral of the story, children? Do you remember? What is the moral of the story? Yes, you are correct. The story teaches, united we stand, divided we fall. The story teaches, united we stand, divided we fall. That means, when we are united, nobody can attack us. But when we are separated, everybody will fall. So, united we stand, divided we fall. So, this is how you read a prose comprehension. So, try to read as many prose or short stories so that you can comprehend easily. And it will develop your vocabularies also. Till we meet in the next video, thank you, children, and stay safe.